everybody. I'm the last presenter before the lunch, so I'll try to not exceed my time, because lunch is most valuable thing sometimes. Today when I came here, I realized that it's that I'm working with Agile around 10 years already. And why I recognize it, because I joined 10 years ago that company. I worked with them for two and a half years, and some of the okay. Okay. Yeah. Is it okay now? Well, so how I learned about my Agile, I just started to work with this company called Microsoft, which develops certain IT projects. And the project teams, they use some methodology which seemed to be very weird at that time, called Scrum. But it was very, very straightforward and logical. I loved it. I started to use it. I tried one project. It was success. Okay. And since that, I'm doing it all the time. All those years, since 2004, I'm doing a project just in Agile way. Sometimes I do projects. Sometimes I do project recovery based on Agile. But always it's the same pattern. And then 2 years ago, I was in one Agile Day meeting. I met some girl from my studies in university. She was very happy, came to me saying, "Oh, Aigar, they saw my label, which is called Agile, because I called my own company Agile." Those days when nobody knew what does it mean. And she said, "Oh, you are Agile. We are Agile too. We are not planning anymore." Okay. And that gave me a very, very big thought about what does it mean Agile for the people. What do they think when they say Agile? And basically what came to me as a unfortunate discovery is that they mean chaos, not development, and this chaotic kind of culture or understanding seems to be coming from the very, very understandable approach that waterfall is equals to structured project development. Everybody knows that waterfalls is structured development. So Agile is something different. If it is not structured, then it's creative, so must be chaotic, which is very, very painful. And since that time, I've been working with many people. People approaching me because I'm labeled as Agile guy, and they say, "Oh, you are who? Which of the kind? Evangelist or practical one? What does it mean? I don't know." And most of them are saying, "Okay, basically, they are." In different words, but what they're saying, okay, we tried it, we cannot survive the waterfall, so we must do something else. We understand that Agile is not for us, so we just cut the corners of waterfall, did something, and we call it our own method, our Agile. Some people are saying that doing Agile is twice more expensive than being waterfall. I can't understand, but actually this is a real quote from real people who is doing this thing here. And some other people are saying that, "Aigar, you're doing everything wrong. This time it worked, but I don't know. I won't try it the next time." Some people are saying, "Aigar, you're not managing the project. It just works itself. We hired you. We get the result. We don't know why, how, but it worked." All of that, well, I use Scrum. It's kind of secret. All of that leads to the feeling that people are not understanding what they are doing. And here came some kind of little philosophy. What is changing? You know, world is changing over the time. Traditions, how people lived 100, 200 years ago, how they lived 10 years ago, are changing slowly. People, because things are changing slowly, people are not noticing them. They can be noticed only from the distance. So it comes from the IT development. This is my understanding. So you are free to interrupt and object it. What I understand, so I would say that when computers were involved, 1045, there came a period of, I would say, infancy or pioneering. Computers were like independent ships in the sea. They had crew, they had building, they had some kind of equipment, and the way how you interacted with the computers was very simple. You just gave them something to do, then they received the feedback, and everything worked. Then you started to think about, then they became smaller and kind of replaceable, then they came. They started to do some business support, and actually what happened, they started to form the crisis, because people started to use computers for everyday life, for business support, not to use a standalone system, but to use them to support them on everyday thing, features. And basically it get worse and worse, which is here. And I believe some of the deadly incident happened when people kind of programmed X-ray devices, which gave 10 times or 100 times more X-rays that were supported. That was allowed, and people died because of IT programs at that time. And something had to be done. And the Ministry of Defense of America, they issued the guidelines, then they issued the standards, and a majority of the world adopted that. They changed IT from the art to the system, to engineering practices. And this is very good. That's the time when waterfall came into the play. People started to do systems in waterfall way. And it worked a little bit, but still around 25% was success, around 50% was challenged, and now another 25 just was disaster. Even if they involved this waterfall, which is supposed to be the holy grail of the programming, which is not. So again, it's my thinking why it was happening so, and what's happening now, and what is changing. We may think about IT systems and in people which interact with them as systems, as complex systems. Everything which we are here, which is happening around, is kind of interaction between systems. Some of the systems, some of the interactions are very small, easy, straightforward, simple systems. I take the pen, I put it back. It's very simple transaction, simple interactions. We are simple system, me and pen. Some systems are complex, like for example, building the bridge. It's a complex system with river, with stone, with a lot of metal and many other things. But that system is static. And static means that I can predict from the beginning how it will end at the end. And it's easy and it's understandable, and you can program it. You can build the house. You can calculate all the materials, all the process from the point when you start to think about building a house. If you're very clever and if you're planning very good. So you start here, you know what will happen there. And there is another kind of system which is called complex adaptive systems. I usually use my example of my own and my ex-wife. When I came home from the work, I usually said, "Hi, how are you?" And she said, "Where have you been?" I said, "In the work." "Really?" Then I get mad a little bit. I say, "Why do you, it's not your business." And then we started to break the plates and other things. We are both complex systems. The same person, I have now another relationships. I'm still coming back from the work and I'm still saying hi. But this time I'm saying, "How are you? Where have you been in work?" "Oh, great." So we go to the movies. Different scenarios based on one party reacts on the other party. So, and coming home, I do not know which scenario might prevail in each situation. Developing IT systems is very the same in implementing IT business. Actually, it's complex adaptive system. In the moment when you create IT systems, when you think about the IT system, you cannot say exactly 100% what will be at the end. Nobody knows. You show something, customers look at that, they make decisions, you program something else. And so it goes some kind of iteratively a little bit. So you make decisions and you get the system at the end. So where the chaos comes to the place. So when you with IT systems, if you kind of follow the idea that if you agree with the idea that IT systems as complex adaptive systems, which helps the business to do things a little bit different than before. So if they are adaptive, it's a moment when you start to think about the system, which you do not know. Nobody knows what it will be at the end. So what you do, you don't know exactly what the system will be at the end. So does customer knows exactly? Never in my practice it has been a case. Even if they say so, it's never been the case. I've done a lot of projects for 20 years or so, and it has never happened. So neither scope nor schedule can be for 100% sure scheduled like it would be for a case in a house. So is price fixed? Usually yes. In this hemisphere, its price is usually fixed. So comes a risk. So there comes a risk. We don't know what to do, but we still have to say how much it will cost. It's kind of a tricky situation. So somebody have to take the risk on his own. In a waterfall, customer is the one who is taking the risk. How it's happening? You just start the project, you produce a lot of documentation, you give it to customer, he signs it, and then it's customer falls that you need something different. When I was a very small one, when I did my first Oracle project in some 20 years ago, we had the tools like Oracle Case, which generates documentation. So actually, I was so happy that somebody generated documentation for myself. So basically, I just printed everything out, and we gave documentation to the customer in kilograms. So we get this delivery was 5 kilograms of documentation. It was excellent project. Customers signed them. It was in English, but they signed them. When they signed them, actually, and we had to do some business process, which obviously changed when we started developing. I said, guys, you signed that you don't need that business process. It's not here. Okay, what to do? It's change request. Great work, great job. Actually, they paid out each time for something. So they took the fault of signing the specification for them. It's waterfall. In Agile, you're saying, okay, we'll do it whenever you want. So in Agile, the developer is saying they will take their responsibility. And they tried usually once. Once they did it, they took the responsibility, found how much does it cost, and then they say, okay, we will not continue Agile practices. We cannot either we continue Agile practice or we'll be bankrupt. So what's happening? Developer refused to take responsibility. Customer do not want to have waterfall. So comes to the mind some processes which is called Agile, the Agile house, more and more companies. I've never seen good Agile company in Latvia. I know two or three people who does Agile as it is, as it should be, but most of them are saying it's not possible. So what comes in? That comes in people which has good name as called Scrumbot. Why Scrumbot? Because Scrum is the biggest Agile methodology currently holding around 60 to 70% of all people claiming doing Agile, they are doing Scrum, around 20% doing XP, and the remaining 5% is doing something different. Scrumbot means people who are saying, yes, we are doing Scrum, which is Agile methodology, but there comes something else. Those people are doing these agile things and fall back. They're not doing daily scrums because it's because overhead. They are not doing retrospectives because waste of time or the greatest project which I've seen agile in my life was I was asked by the customer to make requirements for agile project. I made it. It was 1 million project, actually 2 million project, and the company came, which runs the company, and said they gave iterational agile development plan. It was 1.5 years, and there was 2 iterations. One iteration was 6 months, and another one was 8 months long. It was agile to them, but they failed. Sorry, it was not exactly what they... well, yes. So how to avoid chaos and what to do? And again, my thinking, this is my own thinking. People are used to big words which comes just every 10 years comes something very new. ISO 9000 came as a saver, then it was total quality management, and then as a saver, now agile is kind of claiming that it will save the IT world. And people are just addressing it as normal set of kind of Bible things, like you have here's menu type, you just select something from the menu you like. If you take one, you are agile. And once you read 12 principles of agile, you hardly disagree on the priorities in the first part. Priorities satisfy customer. Of course, welcome changing requirements. Okay, that's new. We can survive it. Deliver frequently, couple of months. Okay, 6 months. Okay, must work together. Yeah, makes sense. So people usually read this first part. They stick to this one thing, we change requirements, and they say, okay, yes, we are start to do. And then there's another part, which is kind of primary measures working software. Okay, it doesn't make sense, does it, for them? I don't know. Sustainable developer, technical excellence. Basically, there is not enough time for them to do that. And actually, taking one part of the menu does not make you agile at all. And probably, what makes you agile is taking the set, the whole set as instruction board for you, just checklist. And if you've done all the checklist, exact 100% all the checklist, then you have started the agile. If one of them fails, you are not agile. So this is thinking pattern difference from what, how it is usually perceived, menu type prescription, to how it should be perceived, checklist before you start. And if you read the Agile Manifesto, it's very easy. It's very clearly and very very kind of understandable to everybody that actually, yes, of course, interactions, working software, and so on, but this is focus. Is focus what we need and want. We still have the processes and tools. We still have the plan. We have a plan, and to become agile, to stay agile. How to validate? How to validate whether the project is agile or not, and whether it's chaos or not? And for some reason, I don't know why probably I'm because I'm just project manager of a company who is managing projects for hire. And people coming for us for the failed projects. And those failed projects very usually are those, most often are those which are saying we are agile. And so basically they set up, so how to distinguish whether you are really agile or you are just claiming you are agile. So first of all, I think there's three things you should think about it, about your process or process you've seen ever in your life. First of all, transparency. I don't know why it's so difficult, and kind of people are always looking at me with suspicion when I'm saying customer and client, they work together. We have repository seen by other party, both parties. We have documents shared. We are inviting to our internal meetings. We show everything. So transparency is not welcomed here in Latvia. I always push it by force. Sometimes, but they do not resist. So transparency is one thing. If it is in, then yes. If it is not, then the problem. Adaptation. You must be able to adapt yourself to something. Currently, I have a project, which is a small project, which failed 6 iterations out of 6. So they are not agile now. So what I will do, actually, what I did, actually, iterations 2 week. So after first 2 iterations, said, please change something. They added additional people. After another two iterations, so something increased. So then it was bad again. So I said we have to do something else. Either we change something within 1 month, or we close this project. And currently, they agreed that I will implement an XP for them with daily stand-ups and process management. So they adapt. Adaption is important. Adaption by force. I'm forcing them to adapt. And inspection. Basically, you cannot trust things. They just happened. So you must have some tools. Usually it's tools. How to know that things are good. Either continuous integration. You check in the code or deploy it. Or you test, you run the tests. Or you do the daily stand-ups or something like that. Inspection not means for punishment, just for understanding where we are. Summary. Agile is not a suit. Wearing the agile suit, saying that you're agile does not make you agile at all. Trust me, it's for so. Agile is excellent tool if you are doing complex adaptive systems, and it is kind of perceived that IT systems are such a systems. If you are doing the agile methodologies, you can get things done a way too more efficient than you were doing before. And difference can be twofold if you're doing right. Though you cannot implement one piece just from setup. You have to take it as a whole. You take it whole, you use it as a whole, and you replace one methodology which is rigid and straightforward with another methodology which is even more rigid. In fact, some of the companies I worked for where I just had to enforce them working in an agile way, I'm not their staff, I'm an outsider, but I'm forcing them to use agile. Some of those people, after the project, team left the company because it was so exhausted with the project. They were happy, but exhausted. Okay, it's not a good example, and it should not be taken as a rule. Yeah, but it's kind of in the circumstances I'm brought in to get this one project done. I do this project done, and then those people leave together. I'm leaving, they are leaving. So it's not a pleasant thing which there's nothing happening. It's these borders. And you must comprehend the logic. If you start doing agile and you are not comprehending it fully, just take the rules as they are, out of the box, no questions, no deviation, just do it as in a book. Then after 3, 4, 5 projects, start deviation, make your own iterative technologies, maybe, but never from the first one. Thank you very much for silence.